I made a udon noodle salad with ginger skirt steak, and how I elevated it is roasted peach and jalapeno puree.
You nailed it.
Thank you.
St. Paul boy is one of a dozen young chefs competing to be king of the kitchen and crushing it. And on Universal Kids Channel, Top Chef Junior, he won the first challenge on the show despite slicing his finger. We're so excited to have Milo Fleming here joining us in the KARE-11 kitchen this morning. Welcome, it's so good to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
You sliced your finger?
I guess so.
Oh, and it's all healed now, so we're
good. Oh yeah, 100% healed.
So I know you can't tell us the outcome of the show. You're still on that
still
we know
on,
of,
yep.
Correct. What has this experience been like for you?
I mean, it's been crazy. It's been a whirlwind. It's like the coolest thing I've done in my life, and I don't know, I couldn't ask for better.
Yeah. How long have you been cooking, and how long have you wanted to be a chef?
I've been cooking for probably like 6 or 7 years now. I started when I was pretty little, and I don't know, I never really wanted to pursue it as a career until like a couple years ago, and that's when I really got like professional with it and really wanted to like pursue it.
So this show, obviously we know what, you know, TV and makes it look all pretty, but this is a pretty intense competition,
oh, yeah,
isn't
really
it?
Intense.
Yeah, tell me about just how intense this is.
I mean, all the kids in the show are super talented, so having to compete with them, first of all, that's a huge challenge. But then, like, doing all these challenges for some super, super, like, talented people that I would have never met before if it weren't for the show, that's, like, nerve-wracking. But then just having to compete, like, on a daily basis with, like full intensity, it's tough, but it's really fun.
And then you're bringing it to these chefs who have traveled the world and traveled the best, ate all the best food.
Mm-hmm.
Are you nervous? I mean, do you get nervous on the show?
I mean, for sure. Every single time. I mean, if you do anything new, you're going to be nervous. But you get used to it, and I know, and you like feel it out and just kind of go with it. And then eventually you're used to it. I mean.
And now eventually would you like to have your own cooking show?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You're going to be your own the own chef show.
Yeah,
I guess. Do you know the name? Have you already thought of the name of it?
Milo's Cooking.
I love it. I think it's got good staying power. Good. All right, so let's cook, man. What are we making today?
Okay, so,
it smells incredible.
Well, thank you. Okay, I'm doing a handmade cavatelli. Cavatelli is a type of pasta, and it's like these little nuggets of dough. And then what I'm doing, this is called a cavatelli board, and you just roll them on it.
And that's
so it.
And
it comes out. This
Perfect.
Little pasta, that's cavatelli.
Can I try one?
Sure, totally.
I thought it was a musical instrument at first, because it was like we were making music earlier.
That's what I was inclined to think it was.
So you just roll it.
Just press it down.
How come mine's not going with
me? Oh, you'll get the hang of it.
What am I doing wrong? Other than
you gotta have, okay. Can I
start again?
You gotta have like, you gotta have to incline like that as between, and then you gotta press and pull.
Oh, press and pull. I wasn't pressing and pulling.
Gotcha. Okay.
Whoops, too much of an incline.
What are you gonna learn, Schwartz?
Never, I am never going to learn. And pull, look at this, look.
There it goes.
Hey! Come on. Yeah. All right, now we got it made. What do we do next?
Okay, so right here we have some cavatelli. This is in the pan. We have some sun-dried tomatoes, some olive oil, a little bit of butter, some lemon juice. We got some salt up in here. Mm-hmm. And then I also sauteed some shallots and garlic, just as like our basic aromatics.
It smells so good.
Thank
Where does this recipe come from?
In here.
You just,
yep.
That's it.
Yeah.
You made it up yourself. That's incredible.
I guess.
How do you go about, is it a lot of testing and fail? And then, okay, I'm going to change this, change that.
I just think of ingredients that, either ingredients that I want to work with or ingredients that I think sound well together.
Yeah.
And then just kind of build a dish around it and maybe a technique that I want to use or like a different plating style. And then from there, I just kind of go.
So I'm guessing you were never like a picky eater as a kid. You like everything.
I mean, I think every kid goes through their picky eater phase. I used to like love mac and cheese and chicken tenders, but probably by age 6, I would like try anything for
once. And then you figured out you could make them even better.
Exactly.
It's incredible.
Yeah.
All right, what else are we doing to this?
Okay, so this right here, this is a Parmesan mousse.
I like everything that sounds about that.
Ha. So basically what it is, I sauteed some garlic and shallots, and then I brought a little bit of cream up to a simmer.
Okay.
And I added some Parmesan, and then I let it chill in the fridge. And now what we're doing is we're just whipping it, because that's like aerating the cream and almost like making whipped cream, but it's savory. So
blend that in there. That's not blending, we're whipping, excuse
me. Yeah, we're whipping.
It's a difference.
This is what's
going on. See, I'd never be a very good TV cook, Bobby can attest.
Okay, so anyways, what we're doing here, we're going to take a little bit of the Parmesan moussey mousse, and then spread it out a little layer under our plate.
Okay. And presentation is key, isn't it?
Presentation is key. You eat with your eyes first. So if something doesn't look good, you're inclined to think that it doesn't taste good.
You eat with your eyes first. I like that saying.
All right, so we're going to get a little spoon.
It's not literal, though.
Spoon of
Don't really eat with
I'm so excited to try this.
People at home.
All right, and then over here, this is some pancetta that I just fried in a pan real quick.
Which is different from bacon, because we just talked about this.
Pancetta has been cured. Bacon's usually smoked.
Okay.
And pancetta has a lot more fat than bacon.
That's good. I like that.
Oh, yeah. And then we're going to do a little fresh basil here.
All right.
don't know if you want, but we got some Parmesan, some Parmesan.
Oh, Reggiano. That looks so good. Hey, Milo's recipe is on KARE-Lovin.com, by the way. You can watch him on Top Chef Junior. It is Friday nights at 7 on Universal Kids. Thanks for coming in. We're going to try this
Thanks
in a second.
Me.
Nice job. We'll be right back.
I'm trying right now.
I'm trying.
We're all running. Yum. We'll be right back.